I'm Ed Schenck. The report is in. Revenue Secretary Rick Chandler, who, by the way, cut me out of the budget years ago when I worked for Jim Doyle, he's back at it, but he was on a statewide tour of focus groups on tax reform with Rebecca Clayfish, Lieutenant Governor. And guess what? 500 people, 22 focus groups, they found that property taxes are too high. What a surprise there. I've been hearing that for 30 years. In fact, the overall tax burden in Wisconsin is in the 10 worst states in the country in terms of state and local taxes as a percentage of income. Maybe it's time to look at the property tax, which half your property tax bill goes to schools. Why should the quality of schools be determined by property tax wealth? I never figured that out. We spend more per capita in Middleton Cross Plains than we do in Milwaukee, where special needs are much higher, even when you throw in the state aids. It really shouldn't be that way. Outgoing Senator Mike Ellis of Neenah, a Republican, said we should have an equalized property tax rate, taking into account income in the district and also property wealth, and you could equalize it accordingly. And you would have state taxes, both income and sales taxes, used to pay for special needs kids, a formula devised by the Department of Public Instruction. You shouldn't base the education of our children on property tax wealth. To me, it's fundamentally unfair. Also, the property tax is really not based on the ability to pay. You can make $40,000 a year, your neighbor is worth $10 million, and you have the same value home. But of course, under the Constitution, all property has to be taxed the same. Maybe we should adjust our thinking. Maybe take the schools off the property tax. Property tax should pay for things like police and fire protection, streets and garbage pickup. We could pay for the rest with sales and income taxes. And if a district wanted to raise spending and wanted to raise their property tax, they could go to a referendum. That's what Mike Ellis wanted to do, but nobody liked it. He was a smart guy. Too bad he got caught saying the wrong things on camera. My 2 cents. My 2 minutes are brought to you by Babe Sports Grill, Capital Consultants, Edge Construction, Greenbush Bakery, and Weedman. And don't forget Babe Sports Grill, my mothership bar, home bar for 20 years, owned by Lynn Haker, where you get smarter after 10 o'clock and where the sports writers know more than the coaches. See you next time.